श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुसाक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। Ramayana has many stories and all these stories have happened in the life of Bhagwan Ramachandra. So these are to be looked upon from two standpoints. Spiritual life is a constant process of learning. If we stop learning, we go old. And if we keep learning, we continue to be young throughout our life. Therefore, if we have been reading Ramayana so many years, we have to make it a point. Today, what I am going to learn from Ramayana? So, 365 days, we will learn 365 things in a year. This process of interacting with the Ramayana story is making the historical fact into the subjective application. And when we apply this knowledge subjectively, then alone there is a meaning to our life. Otherwise, life becomes a burden and a mechanical lifestyle. So yesterday we have seen one or two events. Now we continue with some more events. After Bhagwan Ramachandra was born, there are lots of leelas. What was the time? Bhaya Prakata Krupala Dina Dayala. What was the time? What was the place? What was the situation? How was the climate? There we come across that the whole nature was at its top. There was beautiful air and there was pleasing, nice smell and everything was so cheerful and happy. And in that, right in the afternoon, 12 o'clock, Bhagwan Ramachandra was born, belonging to the solar dynasty. This is one of the events, how Bhagwan Rama is born. Means what? In the external world, the Lord, when He manifests, there has to be a proper time, proper climate, proper environment. Then only the Lord can come. In the same manner, this is one of the biggest and the most important spiritual lesson. Never struggle to have the darshan of Lord. See, many people ask us this question. One youngster asked me this question. Swamiji, have you seen God? So I told him, why should I tell you? It is my personal thing. No. I want to know, have you seen God? Because the same question was asked by Vivekananda to Ramakrishna Paramahansa. I said, look here, you may be Vivekananda, I am not Ramakrishna Paramahansa. So I cannot reply your question. Look here, friends, when we say, have you seen God? What exactly it means, you know? I'll just tell you this through some experience and some examples. Recently, when I visited China, there is one old, maybe about 1400 years old, one Buddhist temple. So I visited that place. And there is one statue of Lord Buddha. It is so tall, almost 30-35 feet and touching the ceiling. So when you look at it, you have to look like this. You can't look in one focus, you can't see the whole picture or the statue of Lord Buddha. You have to see in parts like that, you know. So when we finished that, the person who was conducting me asked this question. Because we are a questionable personality. Anything happening anywhere, we are questioned. As if we are the one, the culprit behind everything. So, the question was asked. that why this statue is so tall, what is the reason? I said, how do I know? You are here, I am here for the first time. You should tell me, it is your country. No, no, we don't know, therefore we ask you. I said, I also don't know, but I can always imagine. Imagination is in our head. We can imagine anything. That freedom we have got. So if we have to imagine, why not imagine creatively and in a learning process? So I told, I said, look here. Can we think ourselves to be without body? Whenever we think ourselves or about ourselves, we are all the time thinking that I am a body, and in the body there is a soul. Like there is a mango, and inside the mango there is a seed. This is what our understanding is, it not? And therefore, if there are n number of bodies, there are n number of souls. Like there are n number of shoes, there are n number of souls, isn't it? Per shoe, one soul. In the same manner, per body, one soul. The spelling is different. That's a different issue. But both are souls only. See? So when I consider myself to be a body, now with that understanding I am the body, when I stand before the Lord, so huge, then I come to discover how insignificant I am. See, friends. So whenever we have to learn from Ramayana, Bhagwan has appeared only when everything was perfect. Then the Lord has taken avatar. So instead of struggling to see God, why not give an opportunity to the God who is inherent in every one of us to express through us? This is all the spiritual life. Rather than struggling to see God, let the God be manifested through us. This is what is the meaning of birth of Lord Rama. Rama is born in the heart of every devotee. Rama is born in the heart of every man of wisdom, provided we allow his manifestation. And how and under what conditions he manifests. See, you must be, you know, cleaning those metal vessels. So how do we clean? We apply the brasso or, you know, the imli or the nimbu and rub it and some kind of chemical powders, and then it becomes bright and clean and shining. Now that shining is not added by the chemicals. The shining is inherent in every metal. But that shining aspect of the metal was covered by the effect of various climatic changes. The heat and the moisture and everything. Because of that, the oxide is formed, and this oxide which is formed on the metal covers the inherent brightness of the metal. So when we add some chemicals or some acidic things, what is done? That oxide is dissolved and the inherent brightness is surfaced. Is it not? Exactly. This is what is the birth of Rama in our heart. See? This is all that we have to do. Now what are the covers which are covering the hidden Rama in our heart? See? So our scriptures tell that there are five covers. See, if there is a bulb and it is having light, but first of all, it is covered by a very thin cloth. Then the second cover is that of the bed sheet. Then the third cover is that of the blanket. The fourth cover on the same bulb is that of a quilt. And the fifth cover is that of a tarpaulin. Now inside the bulb is having a light. And the presence of that bulb and the light is felt first by the protuberance, and second, it is little warmer than other places. But we complain, we are not able to see the light. What is to be done? We don't have to create light. We don't have to create the Rama in us. He is suffocating inside. So what we have to do? First, remove the tarpaulin. Then remove the quilt. Then remove the blanket. And then the bed sheet. And a very thin muslin cloth. And then the hidden light will surface and manifest. To see that hidden light, we don't require any additional light. Let me see whether light is there or not. No, it will manifest itself. Exactly the same process is the birth of Rama in our heart. See, friends. So what has happened objectively, historically in the Treta Yuga, the same has happened hundreds and thousands of times in the lives of all the great masters. See, friends. In Bhagavad Gita it says, Jnani tu atmaiva me vatam. The one who knows me, he is not other than me. See, this is the basic difference in the material knowledge and in the spiritual knowledge. In the material knowledge, the known and the knower, they remain separate. But in case of the subjective knowledge, knowing is being. I cannot know the Lord, I cannot know Rama without being Rama, see? Because the Sat, the existence, and Chit, the knowledge, they are not two. And that is why when we talk about the birth of Bhagavan Ramachandra, externally in our regular celebrations, etc., it is happening, it is required. But it is not once in a while, it is every moment's experience. And that Rama has to manifest, and it will not manifest just like that. Then what was the sadhana? Sadhana, these Dashrajji and Kaushalyaji in the earlier life as Manu and Shatrupa, they have done tapasya for many years. Now what is a tapasya? Tapasya is a willful renunciation of our dependence in the world. That is called as tapasya. See? So we have to start from the first covering, the external most, the body. So the first spiritual practice by which Rama will express through us is body disidentification. Whenever we are identified with the body, we are Mr. Somebody. See, now I'll be taking you deep in your system. Be very attentive. When we are in deep sleep, snoring away, that is why it is called as a sound sleep. You know the sound sleep? Sound sleep is what? Sleep for the self and sound for the public. It is called as a sound sleep. So when we have a sound sleep, in that sound sleep, we are nowhere, we are nobody. And therefore, we don't think. Therefore, we don't desire. And therefore, we are all blissful. Is it not? Be very attentive. So, it is rightly said by mistake. Nobody is happy in this world. It is true. Nobody alone is happy. The moment you become somebody, the misery begins. One day, one person came and asked this question. Swamiji, normally I am okay, but whenever I sit for meditation, I get very disturbed. Lots and lots of thoughts come in our mind. What should I do? Don't sit for meditation. No, no, no. They say we have to do meditation. Say, then do meditation. Then the thoughts come in the mind. Then don't do meditation. Has the doctor told you that meditate and suffer silently? Who told you? No, please tell us, don't brush us away. I say, look here, asking questions, you will not get the answer. Find out. Now, we'll do this experiment right away. Just see and learn this point. You'll see it is so simple. Spiritual life is not a burden. according to your gender, woman or the man. Just sit quiet, close your eyes, and let us play that you are a wife or a husband. Now see what thoughts come in your mind. Stop. Now you play that you are mother or father. See what thoughts came. Stop. Now you play that you are a boss or a subordinate. Stop. Now you play that you are Mr. Nobody. Stop. Now open your eyes and listen. When you are playing as husband or wife or mother or father or a boss or a subordinate, your thoughts were in relation to that position, is it not? But when you were Mr. Nobody, were there any thoughts? So what will be your spiritual practice now? Remain as Mr. Nobody. But our whole life is to prove, you know, I'm so. Once I was invited in this Rotary Club. Here also there must be a Rotary Club. So, Rotary Club, Lions Club, Tigers Club, Buffaloes Club, all kinds of clubs are there. There is not a single human club. Have you seen any here? Because we want only animals around. Inside also the same fellows are sitting. So, once I was called for a Rotary Club, this year only, 31st January, in Anandapur, near Puttaparthi. There was a very big function, so I was there. And after the formal introduction was over. Yesterday, I didn't allow that poor person to talk one word. I only started firing. He must be cursing me, but anyway, this are over. So, when they started introducing. He is Mr. you know, so and so, the governor and his ex-governor and the future governor and the president and the president and the vice president, all. Finally, they say, Swamiji, you can start now. So I said, please help me. Is there any human being here? All are big, big fellows, presidents and governors and all that, you know. See, all the time we are becoming somebody or the other. And whenever we become somebody, you know what happens? We try to prove something. See? And this is how the samsara begins. We don't allow the Rama in us to express. There was a guru and a chela, a shishya, disciple. And they were going together on the banks of Ganges. And the Guru Maharaj told the disciple, Beta, you are young, you must be tired, you must be sleepy this evening. We'll rest here. Anyway, I don't get sleep, so I'll be around Gangaji. See, here there is one, place built up on the bamboos. You can go and sleep there because some animals may come and all that. So, you go and sleep. Tomorrow morning, we'll go and get up and go. Okay, Guru Maharaj, you are really great. So the disciple went up there on that machan and lied down. At 10, 11 o'clock at night, the owner of that place came from that village whose that place was, he came. And he saw with the, you know, lantern, he said, hey, who is there? So this young disciple, he said, who is there? Mahatma ji hu, I am a Mahatma. That owner got so angry. Mahatma banta hai and sleeping. Mahatmas don't sleep. They chant Lord's name and started giving left and right. And gave him a real one. And poor fellow came down. And then what to do at night? This darkness, no light, no light. Next morning, Guru Maharaj came. बेटा हाउ वॉज द नाइट? ओ महाराज इट वॉज सो नाइस, इट इज योर ग्रेस, सो लेट अस गो. नो नो नो, आई लाइक दिस प्लेस, वी स्टे वन मोर डे. एंड इवनिंग केम, देन ही सेड महाराज टुडे यू गो एंड स्लीप देयर, यू नो टुडे आई विल डू द साधना एंड वॉक ऑन द गैंजेस. ओके, महात्मा जी वेंट देयर एंड सैट. एंड महात्मा जी, he has not become a Mahatma, he was a Mahatma, Guru Maharaj, he has not become. So when he went, he said, okay, anyway, he went and sat. And when he sat, again, next day, the owner came with a lantern, and he saw, oh God, today also somebody has come. Who is this? Mahatma is absolutely undisturbed, not speaking one word, sitting quiet. Few abuses were implanted, everything was done, but Mahatma is quiet. And then he saw from, oh, Mahatmaji, namaskar, chamatkar, and then giving nice food and kheer and laddu and jalebi and pressing the legs, and everything was done. Next day, when he comes down, disciple is waiting, Maharaji, how was the night? Because his night was terrible. He expected the same thing must have happened. He said, no, it was pretty good. That man is very nice. He came, he gave me the kheer and the milk and everything. Then the disciple tells, how come they have beaten me? And they have given you so many things. What is the reason? So Mahatma said, you must have become somebody. What did he do? He told, when he came and asked me, I was lying down. Who are you? So I told him, I am a Mahatma. Never become a Mahatma. You have to be a Mahatma. This is what all of us do. We become somebody, and to become somebody, we want to prove something to somebody. And to prove something, we do all kinds of natakbaji. And as a result, our original beauty is hidden behind this fictitious personality. And this is how the inner Ram is not surfacing in our life. See, friends. Therefore, what is meditation? And what for meditation? Is meditation done for silently suffering? No. Meditation is an opportunity given to the divine presence in us to surface. See, when we come out of the sleep, how fresh we become. Can anybody think of saying like this thing, hey man, I was sleeping for 8 hours, now I am damn tired, now let me take rest. No, 8 hours sleep makes you so fresh, recharged. Where from that freshness has come? Because during the deep sleep, we are in tune with the Rama. But this happens in ignorance. When the same thing happens in knowledge, in wisdom, it is called as living in meditation. And therefore, those masters who are living in meditation, they will be yogaratova, bhogaratova, sangaratova, sangavihinaha, yasya brahmani ramate chittam, nandati, nandati, nandati eva. Those who are ever abiding in the divine bliss, they are, whether taking food or not taking food, whether sleeping or not sleeping, talking or not talking, all these external expressions make no difference in their life, because they are abiding in the Rama, that is our essential nature. See, friends. Therefore, let us allow this divine Rama to take birth in our own life. Bhai Pragata Krupala Dina Dayala. See, friends. Therefore, the first spiritual practice is, let us stop becoming somebody or the other in life. We don't have to prove anything to anybody in this world. There is one lady, a Britisher, she asked me one day, Swamiji, I have been listening to you so many years, but I don't know why I am not able to feel the same happiness as you are at home in every place. I don't feel that at-homeness in every place, under every situation. What is the secret? Please tell me, what is the difference between you and me? Please help me to get out of this chaos. I am really miserable. I said, first difference, to be happy and to discover the Ram in you, you must have a beard. See, without beard, Ram doesn't come. That is how I have grown the beard. See, I said, look here, you know what is your problem? Your problem is you are trying to prove something to somebody in this world. Don't try to prove anything to anybody. Be yourself. See, whenever we try to prove something, we act artificially. And when you are yourself, you are so much at ease. See, friends, suppose you have to stand on one leg, artificial condition. Will it not be tiring? And then you want recognition from the people. See, I was standing on one leg, but nobody recognizes. Oh, people thought you are a langdu. No, this is tapasya. Therefore, friends, to allow the Rama in us to express, let us not be hypocrites. Let us be ourselves. Let us not try to prove anything to anybody. Be yourself. Life becomes very easy. Life becomes very simple. Rama means living naturally at ease. See? Now, if this is understood, then what happens? Let us understand our personality. Our personality has got two aspects. One aspect is, what are our possessions? That makes our personality. And second is, how long is our past? These two things are the contents of our personality. If you ask somebody, that's why when people ask me questions, Swamiji, where from you are, where is your ashram, and blah, blah, blah. So I go on bluffing. That is the simplest way to get rid of. Once you know, they ask me, Swamiji, when I talk, you know, in my talk, this is the expression. From our, Punjab, it is like that. So after my lecture is over, then one Punjabi will come and ask, Swamiji, you are from Punjab? Yes. Oh, I am also from Punjab. Where from you are? That person will ask. Now, it is a problem for me. So I say, where from you are? Oh, we are from Amritsar. Then I am from Jalandhar, under the water. Because then they will not ask question, which road? I don't know the road. And then one time I said, I am from Maratha area, Marathi area. Oh, another person, you are from Marathi area? Where from you are? Again the same problem. So, no, where from you are? Oh, I am from Solapur. Oh, I am from Kolhapur. I don't know. Both the places I don't know. Thoko. And in this manner, when I was bluffing, one lady caught me. Say, Swamiji, there you told you are a Punjabi, and here you told you are a Marathi. Tell the truth. Where from you are? I said, Amma, I'll tell you the truth, but don't tell anybody. Okay. See, actually, I am neither a Punjabi nor a Maratha. I am a Paratha. Baap Punjabi, Ma Maratha, dono ka jod ban gaya Paratha. We are constantly trying to talk about our past. So you ask somebody, tell something about you, so they'll start, you know. Dadaji probably, or Bada Dadaji, he came to South Africa from Navsari. You know the life history of a Gujarati? A book I have written, you must have seen Autobiography of a Yogi. Similarly, there is a book called as Autobiography of a Gujarati. That book I have written. Today I went to one Gujarati place, Mahatma Gandhi's place, and I went there. So the Autobiography of a Gujarati is what? Every Gujarati is born in a Navsari. I don't know why. And then the Gujarati Navsari is not happy in Navsari. So he goes to Ahmedabad. And when he goes to Ahmedabad, there Gujarati is not happy in Ahmedabad. So he goes to Mumbai. A Gujarati never goes to Bombay. He goes to Mumbai. And when he goes to Mumbai, there also he is not happy. Then he has to migrate. He goes to USA. When he goes to USA, he is not happy there. He wants the green card. And then he works hard and gets the green card. And then he is also not happy. Now his next project is to become the citizen of USA. And then he works hard. And ultimately he becomes the citizen of USA. By then he is 65 plus. And then he says, let me go back to India. And again he goes back to Navsari. This is how the story of a Gujarati. So you ask anybody, they'll start. Our Dadaji, great Dadaji, came from Navsari to South Africa. Those days they came by, boat, and it was so difficult, and this thing, that thing, blah, blah, blah. That means you keep on listening now four generations of ego. And then this happened, and my father did this thing, and he did this thing, and my father was cutting throats and the pockets. My God. Why? No, he is a tailor. Oh, it's okay then. So, and he was thus, and then I came here, and then I happened to meet you, and then you asked me, and then I told you. In between, go on telling, really? Huh? So he gets inspired. And the moment he comes in the utter present, and then I met you, and you asked me about my life, and I told you. Then what happened? The moment you come in the utter present, we have nothing to talk. See, friends, two components of our personality which do not allow the Rama to take birth. One component is our possessions. Physical possessions and possessions in the form of our past and possession in the form of our memory. See? When I go to many houses, if some recent marriage has happened, then it is a tragedy for me. You must have heard the word Al-Qaeda. Similarly, when I go to these houses, newly married, where it has taken, they will have Ramayana size album. Like, Al-Qaeda, this is album. And then I had to see that. Swamiji, this is me. Oh, this is you? I thought this is a monkey. No. And then we keep on collecting the memories. This is how our I becomes so strong that the Rama is nowhere traceable. Therefore, if the birth of Rama has to take place in our life, these two things are to be cognized. Delete your past. Don't bring it in the present. This is what happens, why the elderly people are not accepted in the younger generation. See, this is the only reason. Old people have nothing except the past. They have no future. And the younger generation has no interest in our past. They are concerned about their future. When these two generations come together, these oldies are constantly talking about their childhood days. Who cares? See? This is how, when somebody is old, the ego is strong. And when the ego is strong, it is easier to make an old person miserable in no time. See? And for a child, even if you give him 1-2 minutes, he'll cry, he'll forget again. And again, he's ready to play. Because the longer the past, stronger the ego, more miserable we are. When we are more miserable, we are more vulnerable. And when we are more vulnerable, the Rama is not allowed to express. See, friends, Bhaye Prakata Krupala Deena Dayala. Just watch this thing. When old people talk, they will be talking only about their past. And it is a great fun, you know. I enjoy this thing. I go somewhere, when I see some old people, I just wind them, chabi de do. And then you don't have to bother, you know. And then keep on. Pahle zamane mein aisa hota tha. Once it happened, you know, in the USA. A Gujarati house I went for taking food. So, that I said, hey, where is your son? Swamiji is sleeping in his room. Please wake him up. I failed. So I went to his room. A huge bed, 7x7. And he was sleeping diagonally in Bhujangasana. In the afternoon, 12:30. So I thought he may not be well. I said, okay, he's not well, it's okay. No, no, Swamiji, everything is okay. He's like that, good for nothing, I'm fed up. Then I found that some story is going to come up. So I said, hey, what about food? What did you prepare? This is another technique to allow the Rama to come out of you. Change the topic quickly. Don't hang on the same topic for a longer period of time. See, this is one of the techniques I was discussing in management. This is equally good for us in our life. If you take a paper, sheet of paper, A4, hold it in your hand. Will it be tiring? No. Hold it for 10 minutes. Will it be tiring? No. Hold it for half an hour. Will it be tiring? No. Hold it for 1 hour. Little bit tiring. Hold it for 8 hours. Oh God, now I can't hold anymore. Very good. Please hold for 2 minutes more. In last 8 hours, when you are holding this paper, so light, has its weight increased? Weight has not increased. Then why are you tired? See, friends, even small stuff, when we hold on to in our mind for a longer period of time, we get tired. Learn to drop the things as early as you can, like you listen to me and drop before going. Now this technique you have. So apply this technique in your life. Don't hold on to the things. See? And when this is understood clearly, you will see our ego will not be allowed to develop. What is the ego? Ego is the same thing, small little thing. We keep on holding for such a long period of time, and then that everything has passed away, but we continue to be miserable. Therefore, stronger the ego, more miserable we are. The more miserable we are, less Rama is expressing through us. Who is Rama? Rama is all bliss. And who are we? All blisters. See the difference. So let the Rama come out of us. That is the meaning of Rama Janmashtami. And who is this Rama born under Naomi? Rama Naomi. Who is this ninth figure in the Rama's birth? Nine is a figure which neither grows nor reduces. See? Remaining in that equanimity all the time is the requirement for Rama to express through us. See? When we say Rama Naomi, what Naomi? Nine means? Nine. One ja nine. Nine, two ja 18. 18 is what? 1 plus 8? 9. 9, 3 ja 27. 27 is what? 2 plus 7? 9. 9, 4 ja 36. 6 plus 3? 9. 9, 9 ja 81. 8 plus 1? 9. 9 is a figure which neither increases nor reduces. That equanimity, when it is attained, we have reached Naomi, dear friends. And on that Naomi, in that equanimity, the Lord is not born. Bhaye prakata krupala. The Lord manifests himself. And when we are in equanimity, worldly things cannot disturb us. There will be disturbances around, but they will have no potency to disturb us. See? You know why we are disturbed? Many people have this expression, oh, the world is too much. The world is not too much. We are too less. See? The strength of the world is borrowed from our weaknesses. If we are a weakling, then the world becomes strong. See, there are so many of us. Now, all are not suffering from diseases. One person suffers because he is so chui-mui. Chui-mui means what? Touch me not. He is so weakling that even there is a news on the TV that there is a heavy snowfall, this fellow gets malaria. Why? He is so weakling. See? Therefore, what is required is that inner strength is manifestation of Rama in our heart. See? What is called as Atma Vishwas is nothing but Paramatma Vishwas. Those who have got absolute self-confidence, they alone have real devotion to the Lord. Devotion to the Lord in the external world and devotion to the Lord in the internal world expresses in these two manners. In the external world, devotion to the Lord is we stop misunderstanding the world. And devotion to the Lord in the internal world or in our heart is in the form of the self-confidence. When we start moving in this world with self-confidence and not misunderstanding the world, you will see Rama is slowly expressing through us. Therefore, let Rama Navami be celebrated every moment in our life. Nine is equanimity. Neither there is change, plus or minus. Bhagavad Gita, second chapter. Bhagavan Krishna gives this as the foundation of spiritual life. Sukha dukkhe same krutva labha labhau jaya jayau tato yuddhaya yujjasva naivam papam avapsasi. When we interact with the world, what will happen? Either we will be victorious or we will be defeated. Like yesterday, your soccer, South Africa versus Brazil. See, when the match was going on, non-stop noise going on. Then last 2-3 minutes, the moment the Brazilians hit the goal, it's a great fun, is it not? See? So when we interact in the world, one of the two things are bound to happen. Either we will win or we will lose. There is no third option. So if we win, we gain. If we lose the game, we are the losers. If we gain, we are happy. If we lose, we are miserable. So this is a cause and effect. So interact in the world, victory and defeat, gain and loss, joy and sorrow. When these three things are no more disturbed, therefore, sukha dukkhe same krutva labha labho jaya jayo. Let us keep our equanimity under all conditions. Then tato yuddhaya yujjasva. Then play the game of life. We will never become miserable in life. See, friends. Therefore, what is called as mamata, and disease is mamata, and medicine is samata, equanimity. This equanimity in the life of Rama is indicated by his date of birth, 9th of Chaitra. Chaitra Shuddha Pratipada. Chaitra Navami, not Pratipada, Navami, the 9th day. Therefore, when our mind remains equanimous under all conditions, then it is the right time for the Lord to manifest. See, friends, equanimity is one of the biggest spiritual practices. keep yourself cool. We all have default settings, you know, like in our computers we have got default settings. We all have default settings. What are our default settings? If I am a wife, the cause of my misery is my husband. If I am a husband, the cause of my misery is my wife or somebody else's wife. If I am a son, the cause of my misery is my parents. If I am a daughter-in-law, the cause of my misery is my mother-in-law. See, we have got all default settings. And therefore, we become again and again disturbed. So let us change these settings. That we are practicing now non-disturbed existence. Don't get disturbed on any issue. This is a very simple spiritual practice. I am not going to tell you take a mala in the hand and start chanting Ram 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 and eat the head of that poor Rama. See? You know, the most miserable and uncomfortable God is Rama. Because everybody eats his head. You must be seeing in your own houses. Suppose your child comes and start talking to you. Mommy, 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 mommy. You say, what do you want, darling? Mommy, what do you want? Mommy, mommy, what do you want? Mommy, 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 mommy. What will you do? Give one. Shut up. Constantly eating my head. In the same manner. Ram, 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 Ram. What do you want? Ram. Because he is not listening. The Ram is talking, but he is busy. Ram, 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 Ram. That is why Rama has got Hanumanji. Hanumanji, lagao. See, don't eat his head. Let him manifest in your own heart. See, friends. Therefore, Bhaye Prakata Krupala Dina Dayala. This Bhagwan is manifested in our heart on the Navami when there is perfect equanimity. And perfect equanimity is not drowsiness of a depressed person. See, two people, those who are dispassionate, those who have perfect dispassion, Vairagya, and those who are fully depressed, both of them's expression are same. A person who is dispassionate, he is not attracted by anything or being in this world. And a person who is depressed, he is also not. What happened? I don't know, depression. So is this the life of the devotee? No. He is fully available in the world. He is fully participating in the world. And yet, Padma Patra Mivambasa, like the lotus leaf in the waters, is living very much in the water, but the water cannot touch it. In the same manner, we have to lead our life dynamically and fully getting involved, and yet we have to keep our equanimity uncontaminated. That is the meaning of the birth of Rama. See, by Prakata Krupala. And in that what is said, then Rama will manifest. We don't have to do anything. Prakatya is self-proclamation. See, the Lord will express Himself. So this is the first thing about Rama Janma. Let the Rama be born in our heart, and the right time is equanimity. And when the equanimity is attained, then Rama is born in His full glory. And what is equanimity? Equanimity has the following expressions. First of all, when we are equanimous, we are at home with ourselves. This is one of the most important spiritual practices. Those people who are not at home with themselves, they cannot be at home with the world. See? Those who are frustrated, depressed, dejected, confused. The other day, one young man met me and he said, Swamiji, I don't smoke, I don't drink, I don't go to clubs, I do everything very sincerely, but I don't know. Nobody likes me, everybody avoids me. What I should do? I shall start drinking, go to clubs, smoke, then everybody will start liking me. See, friends, if I am good to show to the people, then it is an acting of goodness. It is not real goodness. The real goodness expresses naturally. Sarvani bhutani inam samvanchati. Upanishad says, such a master, such a person is loved by everybody. His very presence makes others happy. Because if you are happy with yourself, then alone everybody will be happy with you. See, one day one person asked me this question, Swamiji, how do I know whether God is happy with me or no? I said, forget about God. Are you happy with yourself? See, friends, and we can be happy with ourselves under the following conditions. Number one, we do not carry any load of regrets. So much of load of regret. I wish, one old man told me, when I was young, now I am also old, when I was young, I was maybe in my 20s, he said, Swamiji, had you come in my life 40 years before, I would have totally changed myself. I would not have divorced 3 times. I said, Mahatma ji, 40 years before, my parents were not married. No, he should have come in my life earlier. Means what? Now my life is full of regrets. The load of regret is so terrible, friends. It doesn't allow you even a proper sleep. In Taittiriya Upanishad, this mantra comes. Kimahagam sadhuna karavam, kimahagam papam akaravam iti. These are the two disturbances in the old age. One disturbance is, why did I lead a sinful life when I was young? And second thing, why I did not conduct myself properly when I was young? So these are the problems of omissions and commissions, wrong commissions and the right omissions. When they are piled up on our system, in the old age, there is nothing that we remember, only these things we remember. And then there is the frustration, then there is the depression. See, friends, such a person cannot be at peace with himself. See? And then we don't get sleep, then we become cranky, and then we start shouting at the children. And when the children are sleeping comfortably, the old man is very miserable. Why? Because he doesn't get to sleep and others are sleeping in the house. And for the oldies, there is no problem of waking up in the morning, because whole night he did not sleep. So there is the problem of waking up in the morning. Therefore, friends, let us not allow these regrets to be accumulated and piled up on our system. See? And when we are no more carrying the load of regrets or the wrong omissions, then such a person is at peace with himself. See? Whenever we do something wrong, we are more attentive. We are more committed. When something good happens, it just happens. A child is going somewhere, you saw the child has fallen, you get up and run and help the child and talk to him, give chocolate, blah, 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 and the child is happy. You will forget this event in your life. But if you have cheated somebody, if you have done something wrong, purposely, then that will go deep in our system. See, friends. Therefore, if we are not at peace with ourselves, the only reason is we are carrying the load of the regrets. Now, under this condition, how the Rama will come up? There is only one thing about the load of the regrets or the past that we have been carrying in our life that can help us. And what is that load? Unloading. The technique is select, shift, delete. There is nothing that you can do. You have to just delete it. And to delete that thing, one of the most important spiritual practices is never, never talk about your past. Never talk. If somebody asks you about your past, either change the topic or bluff. See? Otherwise, what happens? Anything you repeat it 100 times, it gathers a status of reality. You try this if you like. You just say, start telling the French, you know, this time when I went to India, you know, I met Sonia Gandhi and Manmohan Singh, and I went there in the parliament, they took me and they garlanded me and they have tabla peti and I was done the aarti. Just go on bluffing. Say it 20 or 100 times to 100 people. You will start feeling really it has happened. Nothing has happened. See, friends. In the same, if the non-existent events, if they are repeated 100 times, they become real in the same manner. When we go on talking about our past, I was here, I was there, I had done this thing, our ego becomes so strong, consolidated. Therefore, to get rid of the regrets of the past, one of the techniques the great teachers have told us, never tell your past to anybody and never ask anybody about their past. Never. See? People come and ask, Swamiji, where from you are, what was your name, are you having parents, they are alive or dead, when they are going to die, why didn't you get married, if you got married, why did you get married, how many children you had, there is no need. See, practice this consciously. See what a difference it makes. And when we drop our past, you will start experiencing tremendous lightness in your life. This I experienced many years before. You know, I had to stay somewhere where in a room I was supposed to stay. And there were many books, shelves, and the whole thing was so much dirty and covered with dust. Anywhere you take out like this and do, you can have vibhuti. So much of dust. So I thought, you know, let me clean the whole thing. And when I wanted to clean, the in charge of the old man, you are not supposed to touch this, okay? I said, I am not doing anything. I am simply cleaning it. And they say cleanliness is next to godliness. So allow me to do. Don't teach me. Don't touch anything. Now what can I do? I had to stay there only. And then meditation. I just want to clean. I am not asking you anything. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Why don't you allow me to do it? Om Trambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukam Yavandhanam Pratyurmukriyam Amrutanam. See, I am just wanting to clean it, you know. I am not asking anything. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Om Trambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukam Yavandhanam. Slowly, Trambakam Yajamahe disappeared. And this particular thought that I want to clean became such a big obsession that 6 months only this is what I did. And one day, by the God's grace, it clicked. I said, hey, what for I am in this place? Am I here for cleaning the shelves? What is the purpose of my taking to this path? And there I discovered, what is the meaning of attachment? Attachment means higher frequency of thoughts flowing towards anything finite is called as attachment. See, and such perfectionists are miserable perfectly in this world. Because they are perfectionists, no doubt they are great, but they expect the whole world to be perfect. And it can never happen. Because God has created this world out of fun. He did not create this world to make you miserable. He made it only for the sake of fun. And what will be fun? So He brings two people of opposite nature together, husband and wife. If the wife is a perfectionist, husband is a Bhole Baba. He will throw the things here and there, and every time the wife will become miserable. And this is how the samsara continues. And from above is watching, maja aa raha hai. See, there was one wife. She was telling me about her husband. Swamiji, I tried to help him. He doesn't understand. He's so shabby and bad habits. I kept quiet. Swamiji, come, I'll show you. She took me to their bedroom. 3-4 places, there were dead bodies of cigarette. The whole cigarette burned and kept there only. He must have taken and kept it there and do something and forgotten. The whole cigarette burned systematically. The dead body was there. Swamiji, see this. So I took a paper and another paper and cleaned it. No, 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 you don't clean it. I said, you told me to show, see this, clean it. No, 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 this is what he does. You tell him not to do. So I called him. I said, husband, come here. There is a complaint against you. Come, see this thing. Why you do like this thing? Don't you throw in the ashtray? Swamiji, I am your disciple. Then, did I teach you this? He said, yes. So how come? You told us, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. This whole world is my house. Yes. If the whole world is my house, is this room not an ashtray? Proportion. So he was a happy-go-lucky. But this lady was so perfectionist and perfectly miserable on everything. I said, then how do you manage with her, Swamiji? She is very good, she is very perfectionist, and I enjoy that. And she doesn't like me, that also I enjoy. I am not miserable. See, friends, we have to be at peace with ourselves. Therefore, about the past, don't bring it in the present at all. Live in the utter present. Like yesterday, I gave you example. Our Bhanuben does a lot of garlands. This garland has taught me a lot. A lot it has taught me. If there are too many flowers, the garland is very long. You reduce the number of flowers, the garland becomes small, 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 small. If there is only one flower, there is no garland, is it not? In the same manner, if we are living only today, then there is no garland of ego. Then only one flower, there is only one. And that one is Bhagwan Rama in our heart. The Lord expresses through us every moment. And for the Lord, there is no past, no present, no future. Rama is the presence. And the presence is fully manifest only in the present. And the present we can remain if we do not bring the past. This presence is Ramanavami. Unless this equanimity is perfectly attained, it is only the tabla piti Rama Janma, not the real one. The real Ram is born in the hearts of the people, of the devotee. Rama is neither in Ayodhya nor Krishna is in Dwarka. Rama and Krishna, they are in the hearts of the people. So they have to be manifesting in our hearts. When we say Ayodhya, Rama's place, Yuddha means a fight. Ayodhya means no fight. No fight means equanimity. When we are not at war with the world, when we are not at war with ourselves, then alone the divine beauty that we are will start expressing. And we are at war with the world under two conditions. In the world, instead of acting, we start reacting. See? And when we react, we can never be doing the thing the right way. You know, on the stage of drama, the people who are acting, they are called as actors, is it not? Are they called as reactors? Oh, Amitabh Bachchan is a great reactor. No, he is an actor. The actor means what? The one who acts, doesn't react. And what is acting? Acting means something is shown, but it is not real. That is called as acting, is it not? One person comes, takes a, you know, what you call a rifle in his hand, and to other person, he pumps the bullet, and other person dies. And after that, the curtain falls. Then both of them get up and go and have a cup of tea. See, they have not died. So neither this fellow has killed nor the other fellow died. It was just a drama, is it not? In the same manner, we have to act in this world, but normally we react in this world. And when we react, the Rama is kept shut. And when we act, Rama alone expresses. See, friends. Therefore, how do we act in life? First of all, in acting, you have to be a perfectionist in your role, but you should not be serious. I am a great actor. One day I was acting in a drama, and in that drama, my role was, I was very miserable, frustrated, and therefore I was crying and telling my dialogues. And you know, the glycerin was put in my, you know, it was in my hanky. So when I was acting, I put glycerin here. Naturally, they started crying. And the pathetic, the whole story and everything. And the whole audience was also crying. In today's world, they have forgotten the old ways of crying. They cry with a tissue paper and through the nose. I don't know why. Normally, people cry in the eyes. But the modern way, they cry through tissue paper. I don't know how it is. Maybe they have opened some new channels and they cry through the moon. Latest technology. See? So when they were crying after seeing my acting on the stage, I was talking to myself, addressing them. Are you fools? I am paid for a fake crying. You have paid and you are really crying. This is just a drama. Don't be serious in this world. See? Once you learn this technique of only acting in this world, not reacting, see what a joy it is. See? Can you help us how to act? Okay. When you go from your work to home, your wife is there, you carry one recyclable flower. You have to use it every day. And you have to go and tell, honey, darling, I was missing the whole day. Therefore, I got this fool for you, being also a fool. Please take this. See what a difference it makes. No, that doesn't mean that you have to really love your wife. No, it is just a drama. There is a tremendous change in the house. Then what the wife should do? She should take, okay, keep it for tomorrow. Come on. See, friends. Take life lightly. Then the Rama is expressing through you. Never become serious in life. If God has created this world out of happiness, how there can be a place for misery? In Rama's life, there was not a day of miserable existence. When we'll take that topic, we'll talk it later. But not a single day Bhagavan Rama was miserable. And if we are miserable and continue to call ourselves to be the devotee of Rama, it is a blasphemy. It is not right. We have no business to be miserable if we are the devotee of Rama. See, friends. If your own son is begging on the roadside, you as a father or a mother, will you feel good? In the same manner, if we claim ourselves to be the devotee of Rama and we are miserable, it is no good. And therefore, let the Rama express through us, and for that we have to stop reacting in the world. Stop reacting. Then only act. And what is acting? Acting is whatever is our role, we have to play it perfectly. That is the meaning of acting. And if you know your role perfectly, all your dialogues, then it becomes a fun, it becomes a joy, it is not a tragedy. See, whenever an actor is even acting a role of a very, let us take a criminal. You must have seen Mahabharat serial when it was coming. Whenever that Shakuni Mama used to come on the stage, the moment he used to come on the stage, how the, you know, audience, oh God, again this fellow has come. But does it mean he was bad? No. He was such a perfect actor. See, in Ramayana serial, when it was going, some mother asked me, Swamiji, my son is so perfect in Ramayana. He has been watching the whole episodes again and again. You ask him any questions, he can reply. He's so good. A small boy, about 5-6 years. So I said, okay, you stay here. I'll ask him a question. I said, hey, you have seen Ramayana? Yes, Swamiji. You ask me anything. I said, okay. Of all the characters that you have seen in Ramayana, you want to become like whom? Swamiji, I want to become like Ravana. Ha, ha, ha. Then I looked at his mother. See? Then Ramanand Sagar might have presented Ramayana, but who likes what? Who knows? Isn't it? Because that Ravana played his role so perfectly well that he was overpowering the performance of Rama. And both of them were only actors. See, friends. Therefore, acting in this world means play your role perfectly. That doesn't mean we have to be bad or good. Do your job cheerfully, happily, perfectly. The moment the job is over, drop everything. And again, you are back to your next job. In this manner, when we start allowing the divinity in us to surface, these are the requirements, these are the preparations. Unless these preparations are done, the ultimate result will not come. Like, you know, when we take food. So today, in the morning, we had a nice breakfast. So many things are prepared. Now for us to finish that food, it takes hardly 3 minutes, 4 minutes. But to prepare that, it takes the whole day. In the same manner, our whole life is required for preparation of the Rama to descend through us. And that preparation is called as leading our life in such a manner that we stop reacting in this world. Whenever we stop reacting in the world, we are in the present perfectly, fully available. See, you are all driving cars from your home to your working place. Every day the same route. But is it every day the same driving? Every driving is a unique driving. It is not the same. Car may be same, you may be same, road may be same, destination may be same, but every driving is a unique one. It cannot be repeated. In the same manner, every day we have to live fully with absolute alertness and complete involvement, yet keeping in tune with the Rama within. See, friends. When this Rama takes birth in us, there is a tremendous change that starts happening around us. You know, Rama's presence is perceived first by the people around us. The flower, its beauty and its fragrance is noticed by the people first and then by the flower itself. The flower is not able to recognize his own beauty and fragrance. It is others. In the same manner, our spiritual unfoldment, the birth of Rama in our heart, starts expressing as the people start observing change in us. Now we are not the same old stuff, getting disturbed on every small issue, demanding the things, insisting, obsessed. No, all these things start disappearing and we are at peace under all conditions. See friends, this is how the Rama Janma takes place in our heart every day, nay, in every experience. That experience, which is an experience of joy, or that experience which is expressing joy, is called as the birth of Rama. Normally, whatever we do for getting happiness. Whatever we speak for getting happiness. Whatever we think for getting happiness. And whenever we do anything for getting, we forget the God. On the contrary, let every action express happiness. Let every word express happiness. Let every thought express happiness. When action, words and thoughts express happiness, Rama Janma has taken place in our heart. See? Mahe Prakata Krupala Dina Dayala. And when Bhagwan Ram is born in our heart, we are no more leading a life of a beggar in this world. I want this thing, I want that thing, I want this thing. Our devotion to the Lord is nothing but signing an MOU. Oh God, I want this thing. If you do this thing, I'll give you this thing, okay? That is not the devotion, that is not Rama Janma. So on this issue, we'll see something more tomorrow. Today's episode of Rama Janma is over. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.